Hannah. Hey, morning. For real, this is serious. Did you hear about that kidnapping? No, seriously, the kidnapping. There was a kidnapping in my room, and I woke him up, and he was not funny. I don't like that kidnapping stuff. No, not in my room. How you feel about that joke? Hannah, is that all I get? That's a fake laugh, Hannah.
Put this theory of a smile being contagious to the test.
Good morning.
Hey, look at me. Yeah! Move your hand for a second. Here I am, MacArthur High School student. That was easy. Comes in here sleepy and tired every day. Yeah! Yes!
But I was challenged. And so, Mr. Morrow always steps up to a challenge. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the worm. Ouch! It hurts!
So I want to show you guys something. Look how awesome this is. This, seriously, this has never, ever happened. I've gotten just blessed with so many things from my kiddos today. I've got Valentine's Day cards and stuffed animals and candies and chocolates. Things I haven't even opened yet. Chocolate kisses. Look at this. Happy Valentine's Day, Lester, from the Delgado Paez families. Look, the best bus driver ever. So no, I am just so very blessed, and I can't get off this bus acting and feeling emotional, so I need to try to man up a little bit here on Valentine's Day. Well, it's not the actual Valentine's Day, but it's the day that the kids are having their parties at school. And, no, seriously, this is just unheard of. This is just unheard of. And so I'm so very blessed. These kids are so good to me. What I'm gonna do, let me close my door, turn off my bus. Oh, no, hold on. Sheesh, that's embarrassing. I just thought, you know what, let's just have my own little gift and goodies bus edition. Okay, so candies. This over here looks like it's a coffee mug, obviously, with a little gorilla. That's sweet. There's also a Valentine's Day card with Pokemon. That's cute. I got this awesome tattoo. I think I've already talked about that. Okay. Oh, okay, that's just the bottom. Okay, so there's one. Over here, yeah, this ought to be interesting. You know, but does this not exemplify everything that you love about kids? Listen, I'm not gonna talk about it because it's possible that the kid could be watching my videos and or the family, but this almost makes me wanna cry. And for obvious reasons, they gave the best gift they could come up with. And I love that. I absolutely love that. A little pair of slippers that has been worn around the house for a while. Oh, I love that. And then here's the card. And I'm trying to do this with one hand. So bear with me a minute. You're the best. I wish there were a name on this one here because I don't honestly recall which kid did what. Sheesh, I cannot go into the school like this. Chocolate kisses. I got a lot of chocolate candies. So much for that diet that I've been on. Astrid, Leo, Okay, so I'll start putting all these things back into the packages. Folks, you don't know how blessed I am. You know, having a year with off and on school, and let me turn my camera around. So you just don't know how blessed, and I'm feeling so emotional. And this is the part of me that I wish I could change. There has to be some kind of a pill for this, to a man up pill. But, you know, in a year that has been, well, the last 2 years with so many crazy changes in the world and working, then not working, then online working, then, I mean, you just name it. And now just driving this bus and, so I will say that I feel like my strength in teaching has always been the ability to create relationships where they normally can't exist. You know, there are so many kids that are very, very hard to reach. And they come to school with so much on their plate. And a lot of teachers don't take into account that school is that one place. I hope that no one's watching me. School is that one place where they feel safe, where they're supposed to feel safe, and they're supposed to feel welcome and loved and fed. And there's so much that they're not getting from home. And I'm not trying to I know that a lot of folks are going through hard times, but kids need a safe place. And sometimes school is the place that happens. And so my boss, when she talked about driving the bus, you know, for the morning and the afternoon route, I thought, you know, a lowly bus driver, you know, but you don't realize sometimes this is the first, this is from their entire school day experience. This is the first person that they see in the morning and the last person they see as far as related to the school in the afternoon. And so greeting them at the door and trying to be kind to their families that are waiting with them, trying to be understanding when they're running late, not scream and holler, allowing them to, you know, telling them stories. You don't realize, and the bus drivers out there get this, but you don't realize how much talking you do as a bus driver. Not screaming and shouting, but just talking. And they get to know you, and they know your story, and you get to know them and their stories. And folks, you see their homes, you see their living conditions, and you just, you know, you see the struggle, and the struggle is real. And so I'll just get to the point. So on days like today, when all of a sudden you find yourself being showered with gifts from a lot of students who may not have a whole lot, families who don't have a whole lot, yet they found a way to go to the store and pick out something for you. Or then, in the case of the little girl that found whatever was special to her, her little slippers. And to gift something, someone, to someone, you know, that just means so very much to me. And so I'm like, man up, Lester. Sheesh, what's wrong with me? I'm sitting here in a very busy school parking lot, and there's people dropping by. And I hope that no one can hear me on this bus. My lights are on. Okay. I got to compose myself now. And take off this big set of overalls that I'm wearing. Get back into actual clothes. And it's hard to get out every morning and get on that cold bus. And then, of course, in the summertime, get on a hot bus and the sweat and, you know, but you don't understand. On days like today, it makes it so very worth it. And my boss was right with what she said. She said that relationships can be built just as strong and just as needed on a school bus as what they can inside the classroom. And I don't think that's ever been more obvious than today, you know? And so it's not, and then for the kids who did not gift, that doesn't matter, because their gift is that smile and their gift is that wave when that, you know, when they see you coming, and the little guy that, you know, who doesn't even ride the bus, it just is enchanted with this school bus. And there's more than just that one. So I'm going to go ahead and take this video opportunity and share with y'all some of my most special moments. I can't go into school like this. I cannot go in that school like this, because they're going to send me home or call somebody.
They're going to call somebody on me. I'm going to go ahead and just go ahead and make this a worthwhile video and share some moments, some of my most special moments as a teacher. And yeah, and I'm going to compose myself, okay? Watch, ready?
Let me just say that was a beautiful, beautiful song. Yes. Thank you, girl. That was beautiful. Now, you guys wrote that together? Now, let me get this straight. So, you called each other last night, and on the phone, y'all made up a brand new song for me. That's perfect. Did y'all sing to each other on the phone?
Yeah.
What was your mom's and dad's doing? Were they freaking out?
No, they were in the room.
Okay. Well, thank you, girl.
So let's say that there's someone that you like and that person likes you back, but there's too many people telling you that he's not good for you, but they're telling you that he's going to play with you. But he doesn't show that. He shows that he cares about you and he wants something real with you.
So so you have to decide, you listen to your heart or to your head?
That's
so what
problem.
Is your heart? That's the problem. So what does your heart tell you?
It tells to don't care what people say and just try something real. But my head says that they may be real telling me that and because they care about me.
So that is a dilemma. So what are you going to do?
I don't know.
You have to decide, because anytime you put yourself out there, it's a risk. However, sometimes the risk is worth the reward. You understand what I mean by that, or not really? So, if you choose to allow this person into your life and he ends up hurting you, then your friends were right. But if you don't let him into your life, then you're going to miss out on whatever he brings to you, the way you feel right now. It's a risk, but there's also a reward. So what are you going to do? Don't you wish that things were easier?
Yeah.
I know. Life is difficult, isn't it? I'm sorry. You know, even at my age, it doesn't get much easier than that. You know, it's still, you have to always decide what your heart tells you and what your head tells you. And sometimes you have to make a tough decision. You take a chance. It's always a chance. There's always a risk involved. But I think that you cannot go wrong if you move slow and you allow him to take baby steps to earn, because there has to be a reason people keep telling you that. Maybe he's hurt somebody else. Maybe he's hurt more than one person. Or maybe that's because he didn't really care for them the way he cares for you.
That's the thing. It's hard to know. You just need... For me, I'm thinking just to allow that person in my life and see what's happening. Because if I don't allow that person, I'm going to miss something that I may not find.
Oh, that's
well said. If you don't allow that person, you might miss something. Yeah.
But then if I try, maybe things will not work, but you go through something, you learn.
You learn.
You take it very slow though, right? I'm so proud of you.
Guys, you need to learn to take me more seriously.
Yo, what is up, Fortnite? What's up, Pleasant Park? My name is Marshmallow, and thank you for coming out today and making history with me. You guys ready?
Class, they've totally frozen on me. This is the weirdest thing. How bizarre is this? Kids? Kids. Students.
Black Beatles in the city, be back immediately to confiscate the money. But it is seven shoes.
What's wrong with y'all? Hey. Very eerie. These students. Just totally froze.
This contest, ball catching, whoever can catch one is soda. Angel over here says he's ready for his challenge. Now, as you already know, Angel has a little bit harder time.
Are you ready to dominate?
Let's go.
Yeah.
Can y'all, do y'all believe he can do it?
Yeah!
Ready, Angel?
Oh, yeah.
Here come, kick. What do you want to say to the camera?
Bye.
Bye? I guess it's over.